Hello everyone, welcome to episode number one of Cooking with Roberto. Ta-da! Before we start cooking today, we're gonna do a quick turn in our temporary apartment. So this is the living room, dining room area. TV set. This is how we get to our balcony. We have a very nice view of the Cordillera de los Andes, which is the largest mountain chain in the whole world. It's very, very beautiful. As you can see, there is very little traffic and very few people outside because of the quarantine. So the wife and I decided to make some special episode of cooking different foods, my style. Welcome everyone. Let's continue with the tour. This is a small hallway with the visitor's bathroom and two small bedrooms that we're not gonna look into it because they're a real mess. This is where the magic happens. This is our room. On the right side, we have the closet. Ta-da! Here we also have a second balcony. This is smaller than the other one. And this is an old part of Santiago. We are located in San Miguel. There is not that many high-rise buildings. Still a lot of small houses. For the first episode of Cooking with Roberto, we're gonna make some quick fajitas. Here are the ingredients. We have some lomo or sirloin. We have onion, garlic, avocados, cilantro, tomato, black beans, merquén, which is a Chilean smoked type chili, tajin, which is my wife's favorite spice. We have bell peppers. We have tortillas. We have a pan. A cast iron pan that is warming up bit by bit right now, and my new toy, my new knife. So let's start. Okay, for this recipe we're only gonna use half an onion. I'm not a big fan of onions. I like the flavor a little bit, but it's not my favorite thing. But we actually need it in order to flavor our fajitas. I'm gonna give it a quick look. You don't have to be very thin with the cast. You have to be able to sense the onions in the fajita. So we're gonna prep all the ingredients before we actually put it in the griddle. So onions are done. I'm gonna put the onions together with the peppers because I'm gonna throw them at the same time. Now we're gonna cut the beef. The last thing we're gonna do is the guacamole because we want the avocado to be very, very fresh. Okay, we're gonna cut the meat in strips. We're gonna make sure that they are about the same width because we want them to be cooked at about the same time. We had a little bit of a hard time trying to get a good quality beef because of the quarantine, so we hope this meat is just right. My wife likes the beef to be very tender. I like it to be a little bit tough so I can actually says that I'm eating meat. I can say that I'm a true carnivore. Check the temperature of the pan. Nope, still needs to be hotter. That's the thing about cast iron pans. They take longer to warm, but the heat is actually quite even. I really like to cook meat and pork using cast iron rather than aluminum or stainless steel. Okay, now we're gonna chop the cilantro. I'm trying to arrange them nicely. It doesn't have to be very fine, again, it's all about the textures. Some people like the leaves only, some people like the stem, some people like both. I like the leaves a lot and not so much the stem, so I'm gonna remove the big chunks of stem. Okay, now we're gonna put this, which is the cilantro, in a bowl for plate. This is the same bowl that we're gonna mix the guacamole. Okay, let's check the temperature of the griddle. It's getting nice and even. I put a little bit of olive oil beforehand so we can actually cure the griddle. Before putting the meat in the griddle, I'm gonna add a little bit of tahini, a little bit of cayenne to give it a smoky flavor because we're cooking it, of course. And I'm gonna add the salt. The meat is actually up to taste. I like it salty, my wife not so much. So we kind of meet in the middle. A little bit more honey. And the baby. I wish I can have you guys smell it, because the meat, the onion, the pepper, the tahini and the mexican make a very, very nice combination. I wish I could make it into a perfume, you know, and wear it every day.
Wow!
Okay, we're gonna lower the temperature a little bit, and we're gonna let it cook. Mm-hmm. Okay, before the meat or the carne is ready, we pour the black beans into a bowl that we're gonna heat on the microwave, and we prepare the avocado and the tomatoes for the guacamole. So I'm gonna start by trying to puree the avocado. The cilantro. Again, some people like it chunky, some people like it creamy. I like it somewhere in between. So I'm gonna add a bit of tomato. This is to taste. I'm gonna leave some tomato to add later if I want to. My favorite spice. A little bit of salt. Yes, a little bit. And let's give it a quick mix. Some lemon juice for the kick. This is to taste again. Masala, very good. A little trick, if you're gonna warm up tortillas in the microwave, put a paper towel with a bit of water and warm it for a couple of seconds. This smells really good. Okay, the meat is ready. The tortilla is warm. The black beans are warm, so we're gonna make our fajita. Again, this is a matter of taste. I like to put a little bit of guacamole at the bottom. Making sure you grab onions, you grab bell pepper, and everything. And I'm gonna top it with some black beans. Now yeast kick. The test. 1, 2, 3. Very. Okay, guys, see you soon in episode number 2. Bye.